Punchboard Media,
where we all
bring something
to the table.
Pull up a chair
at punchboardmedia.com.
So more Origins 2019. We are here with Connor with Inside Up Games. So Connor, what do we have going on here today?
First of all, I'm going to apologize for my voice. Hopefully you can still hear me by the end of this. We have a whole bunch going on. We're in a booth way larger than what we used to have, which is great because you can tell we're surrounded by demos. But the one behind us right now is our latest, which is Seven Souls. It was on Kickstarter, June 5th. I don't know when we are anymore. It ended at the start of June. There we go. It is my first foray into the Lovecraftian universe.
Okay.
So with my own unique twist on it, what I've done is I've taken the players, instead of being investigators, now we are the ancient old ones. We are the bad guys. Okay. We will be competing over the control of the same seven souls, the same cultists, the same acolytes, the same prophets, trying to use them to gather more power, more souls, and more resolve to compete and kind of take over the world. There's a whole bunch going on, as you can see, and it's one of those things that's pretty easy to learn, but a little bit harder to master, in that you're going to be doing simultaneous action selection at the three locations, trying to grab more supplies as you can, from the resolve decks, to the souls, which are victory points, to the power, which you'll use to power up your attacks, but also purchase the altars. Some beautiful artwork that I have to point out by an artist named Reese App Gwynn. Really happy with everything he's done, turned in, and I'm super excited because one of the Kickstarter goals we reached was actually more monster artwork. So there are revelation cards in the game, which are basically like your secret objective, and you'll choose between two, discarding one, and that one will be the monster that you're going to inhabit, which elder god or which ancient one you're going to be, and whether you want the most souls, the most fear, whether you want to be the whatever it is in the game, and that's kind of a little bit of fun, but it means I'm actually getting new artwork from him all the time, and the artwork is my favorite part of any game.
And then we have Summer over here, which is like your classic game almost.
Yeah, so Summer was my baby. So Summer was my first board game into the world, and that is our survival game for 1 to 6 players. You can play competitively, cooperatively, or solo on a two-sided board. So this one right here is set up, unfortunately, upside down for the camera, but it was a cooperative mode where these players attempted to ascend and then descend a deadly mountain. It has everything from tile laying and route building, different types of terrain, difficulty settings from very easy to very hard, asymmetrical player boards with their own stats and ability, where players have to track their own food and oxygen. But the more they carry, the heavier they get. And as their weight increases, their speed will decrease. So some resource management and press your luck. It's got 200 unique cards in the game. It's got 2 expansions now, a Yeti in the back, which has fallen over apparently, and our latest one, which is our team's expansion that hit Kickstarter in March. It's going really, really well. We're running back-to-back demos here, which is fantastic, because from my personal experience, most of my games are the games that are fun to play. So even if people haven't heard of them, we get them to sit down, we get them to play it, and that helps spread the word a little bit more.
Yeah, one thing I like about Inside Up is you have such unique games. Like, you look at Summit, it doesn't look like Gorus Maximus. It doesn't look like your new games or anything like that. Everything is so unique, but then they're all fun.
Well, thank you, and that's something that's really important to me, and pardon me. That's a point I try to make with each game, is I have a very distinctive art style, a very distinctive theme and genre to the game, to try to really diversify the portfolio, but to reach out to people. So someone might walk by and look at someone and say, that's way too many pieces, I don't want to even get into that. And they might go by Vault Assault, a real-time Cops Rambler's dice game, a little bit more family-friendly, a little bit lighter. Or maybe they just want a simple trick-taking card game, but for 1 to 8 players with some unique twists. So depending what they're doing, it's hopefully going to reach out to them. And as I said before, the art is such a big part of the game for me that I get the chance of working with some of these amazing artists to kind of bring my game to reality.
It's awesome. So yeah, if you're here at Origins, definitely come by. We're in Hall C.
Yeah, C201.
So definitely come by, check this out, and also try to find them at your local game store as well.
Yes, please do. Thank you so much.
Thank you.